Hello, have you ever realized that with time all the shows became Grey's Anatomy? They start with clear premises, but as the seasons progress, Dr. House will no longer practice clinic, nor Harvey Specter solve legal cases with a glimpse. Instead, all they have is trouble dating. If that is in a few seasons, imagine when the show is running for millennia. Like the Cyclopean walls, forgotten are all the answers, the why, the who, especially the how the walls are made, replaced by dating, pushing them to act young. Take this wall in Mycenae. Here we can see three types of construction, with the best one, the fitted stones in the middle, being the older. So, what is the story there? The screenplay is weirder than that episode where everybody sings. Let's watch it. Andromeda was an Ethiopian princess. Her father, the king, claimed she was prettier than some fish-lipped ladies, and the sea god Poseidon got so offended, he punishes the whole country by sending him a killer squid. Instead of fighting the beast, the Ethiopians decide the best course of action was feeding Andromeda to the squid, having her wait for the creature on a beach, all naked. Still, fearing she might try to escape, they tied the naked princess to a rock. Percy, not Jackson, was flying by, after killing the Medusa. He saw a tied naked babe on the beach, and dived to marry her. In his way, Percy turns into stone a bunch of secondary characters, and one nasty squid, all petrified with the gaze from Medusa's head. One of those left stone dead was Percy's grandfather, who, in a hint from the oracle at Delphi, locked his daughter, Percy's mom, to prevent being killed by his descendants. But Percy did kill his grandfather, and thus inherited the throne of Tiryns, promptly swapping crowns with his cousin to establish himself as the king of Mycenae. In his new city, Percy gets help from the Cyclopes to build walls. He lets his 8 sons set up an Australian soap opera to last the whole Bronze Age, achieving enough power to destroy Troy until eventually being lost to Hubris, entering the Greek Dark Ages. The end. It's complicated, I know. That's why academics or TV critics only want to date younger walls. Insisting that sets with Cyclopean walls, like the Emancipation Wall at Delphi or the Pnyx Hill in Athens, were built in the 6th century BC, and not during that old melodramatic Mycenaean era. But I'm not here to please the critics, so let's check the stones. For starters, at the end of the BC era, nowhere in the old world were Cyclopean 3D puzzles being built. By then, we have properly scripted stories with records left by the Romans, but we don't have Cyclopes. A few centuries before, in the 4th century BC, all the new buildings, such as the Nike in Athens, were squared reality formats, also without Cyclopes. Critics thus concede that Cyclopes are a bit older than the Roman screenplays or the Nike store, pushing them back to the 6th century BC, right at the end of the Greek Dark Ages. However, during that 6 BC time, the major show running was This is Sparta. And Sparta has no Cyclops. The same for sports. Olympus, with its famous games played in that period, not including transathletes nor Cyclops. These two cities, Sparta and Olympus, were major sets in the 6th BC and do not have Cyclopean walls. Wherever we can find Cyclopean walls, it is either Bronze Age old, such as Mycenae or Tiryns, or else, like in Delphi and Athens, cities that managed to stay relevant both before and after the Greek Dark Ages. Even if experts say the fine walls in there are young, if those places are old, the walls could be into older dating too. Here's the season finale reveal. Mycenae was abandoned at the end of the Perseus Bronze Age, so everything there is older than experts like to date, with the Lion Gate and its big boulders being at least from the 14th century BC. The big blocks for the Lion Gate are in front of polygonal masonry, so the polygonal bit is even older than 14 BC. Whilst on the other side, also younger than the polygonal, we have some big stones, filled with smaller ones, like some sort of bad lip filling, a cheap procedure that makes the younger wall look worse. This poor aesthetic work is massively overdone in nearby Tiryns. There, almost all the walls have been facelifted with rubble. In my opinion, these fillers are later renovations. Instead of assuming the walls through age, somewhere along the way, a nip-tuck made them look worse than old. In that recurring plot twist, whereas Cyclopean masonry is both older than dating and covered in cheaper work. To finish, here's a couple of Easter eggs. 1. Percy married Andromeda, who was a princess of Ethiopia. Well done, but it's not that. She could be either from Arabia or Libya, as the name relates to the Nile. And another one. The grandfather of Percy was called Aegyptus because he was a pharaoh. So, both Andromeda and Percy originate in the River Nile. Thus, despite all the confusion due to that turn into Grey's Anatomy effect, the Percy not Jackson story features a clear argument for Cyclopean masonry being brought from Egypt into Greece. Let's end with a cliffhanger. As next, we'll go to not Egypt but Japan, which is far and will take me a while. In the meantime, don't let YouTube hurt the channel. Please leave a like and I'll be back.